Hi everybody, my name is Gary and welcome to the Outdoor POV. Today I'm going to show you how to create a course using Garmin Connect Online and then send that to your GPS Garmin watch. You can create a course using the Garmin Connect app, but in my opinion the interface is rubbish, so I won't be showing you that. Before we get started, could you give this video a thumbs up and a share? Also, please subscribe too and hit that notification bell. It's a great way for you guys to be informed every time we upload a new video. Also, if you're going to make an Amazon purchase anytime soon, then please consider clicking through from one of our affiliate links below. It's such a great way to support this channel. Okay, the first thing you need to do is open up the Garmin Connect website and log in. And once you are there, you've got your home screen, and we will go to this left-hand menu, down to training, and then to courses. Nice and simple. To the left there is a list of courses I've previously created, so we'll just ignore those. And I will go to this blue button here and press create a course. Then you'll be asked to create a course type, and for this purpose, we're going to do running, continue. And then this is kind of your course section. I'll rename it and we'll just keep it 111 POV test. So I should be able to find that green tick. Let's save that course. And we will also just narrow down the location. We are going to go to Hartlepool for this. And there you go, it's kind of zoomed in on Hartlepool. Scroll in with the mouse wheel and you'll see all these different purple lines. These are basically Garmin's collected all this data over the years of popular places people have been when they've been using their Garmin devices. And what is great, you've got this popular routing, the kind of section highlighted here. When you tap on one of these purple, then Garmin, this course planner, will just lock on those lines, and it's very easy to create a course. Now you can override that, click on freehand and go wherever you want. We'll just undo that, and that is quite handy. For example, if you are in a remote area and there's not enough data, so Garmin haven't created one of these kind of purple lines, so you just have to kind of fill in the gap yourself. Now sometimes when you try and use popular routing and there's not a route, then Garmin kind of has to do its kind of best guess, and it doesn't always work, so the freehand feature is a very good way just to kind of keep things right. So we'll just click this around, keep going all the way, and hopefully we'll get back to Pilot Pier. There it is. And what I'll do, actually, I'll show you, it does work quite well. I will go all the way here. Hopefully it will just do it for me. Great. So we've got just over 3 miles. Named as 111 POV test. Then we've got the blue button here, save new course. Boom. Save that, and what that has done also, it's saved it there in Garmin Connect Online, and it will also be now saved in your courses on your Garmin Connect app. And for me, that's the best way to get this onto your device. So that's where we are going to head now. Okay, the first thing you need to do is go to the Garmin Connect app and tap on that. I'm using Garmin Connect on an Apple device. I'm hoping that the interface is the same for an Android device, but I don't know, so apologies for that. Then the first screen you'll get will be the My Day screen. In the bottom right hand corner, you'll see three dots and the word more. Tap on that, and then you will see training fourth from the top. Tap on that. Courses. Now hopefully our 111 course test will be there. Fantastic. Right at the very top, 111 POV test. We will tap on that just to double check everything looks okay. And that's, yeah, that was pretty good. Now at the very top of the screen, you'll see the three little blue dots. Tap on that, and there you go. Send to device. Really simple. Send. My Fenix 6X Pro Solo is connected. That's good. Tap on the watch, then it will tick. That has gone to the device now, but what I always do is just go back, the top left hand there, there's a little arrow, tap, 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 go all the way back, and then I tick the My Day screen at the very bottom left. You'll be presented with your My Day again. At the very top there, you've got the blue sinking kind of circular arrows. Tap on that wheel, that'll stop spinning, and then when that has gone green, at the top there, just like you did, your course will be on your watch, and that is what we'll do now. Okay, we come over to our watch, and I'm going to assume that we're going to do this course as a run. So I'll press this top right hand button to get into our activities. These are just my pre-installed activities, and I'm going to go to run. I'll press the top one again. Then I'll press this middle one. I'll just tap that, and there you go, straight away you'll see courses, training calendar, workouts, etc, etc. But for the purpose of this, we need courses. Hopefully that one that we created is there, and there we go, fantastic. 111 POV test. We will just tap on that top right hand. It's not loading the course, and just to double check it is what we hoped it is, tap top right. And there you go, you can see the kind of loop we did around Hartlepool Headland. That's fantastic. So bottom right to go back, and then when you're ready to start your activity, you kind of scroll up to the do course and then top right, and then that is now loading your activity. And when you get to the kind of correct place and your GPS will pick it up, you are then ready to go. And just like with any normal activity, when you're ready to start it, press the top right, and that is that. Off you go.
I really hope this Garmin tutorial helped. If it did, give it a thumbs up and a share. Also, please subscribe to this channel and hit that notification bell too. As always, thanks for watching. I really appreciate it. Please comment below if this tutorial helped. Thanks again for watching. You take care, everybody, and I will see you all soon.